ते नमः।
हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल आदित्य 11TTT। टुडे वी आर हियर विद अ प्रोग्रामर विच इज़ अ वेरी स्मॉलेस्ट प्रोग्रामर दैट इज CS341A। दिस इज़ वन ऑफ द चीपेस्ट प्रोग्रामर विच इज़ अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट। ओके, CH341A, दिस इज़ अ बायस मिनी प्रोग्रामर विच कैन हेल्प यू टू फ्लैश बायस एज वेल एज KB9012IO ऑल्सो। सो इन दिस प्रोग्रामर, एज यू कैन सी दिस बिलो पार्ट 1, 2, 3, 4 पार्ट इज फॉर द 25 सीरीज IC, द अपर पार्ट इज फॉर द 24 सीरीज IC। ओके, सो दिस इज द प्रोग्रामर एंड दिस पिंस आर फॉर KB9012 प्रोग्रामिंग, फ्लैश प्रोग्रामिंग। यू कैन सी देर आर द पिंस, आई विल शो यू दिस पिंस आर फॉर KB9012 प्रोग्रामिंग। यू कैन सी इट इज रिटन ओवर हियर CLK CS MOSI MIOS ground 3.35 volt, and this is for RX and TX signal reading, and this below part is for 25 series flashing and upper part is for EEPROM. This is SPI bias, this is EEPROM bias. So this is how you can use the programmer for the functions which are been mentioned in the programmer. So we are going to install this programmer and have a look how we can flash this bias is over here, this bias using this clip. So I'll be flashing the bias using this clip, and I'll tell you how you can see pin number one of the bias over here and pin number one of this clip later in the video. So let's get started with the installation of this bias programmer and move towards the flashing of this bias with the help of this clip. Now, so here we are going to install the CH431A. So we are going to see how to install this programmer. First, we are going to connect the programmer. As soon as you connect, you can see there is an error message you are getting over here. Now we go to device manager. You can see here is an unknown device. Now we have already downloaded the software of this programmer. We are going to extract it first. So now we are going inside. Here you can see CH431A drivers are there. From here we have to select the first option, because mine is Windows 7, so I am using this. Now I have to press on yes. Now here I have to simply press on the install button. Now as soon as it's been installed, you can see the programmer has been installed. Now it is ready to use. Now I am going back over here and I'll start the interface. This is interface AS programmer. Now here you can see there are options. First you have to go to the language option, and here you can select the language English. Now you have to go to the hardware, where you have to select CS341A. Now here we are going to read the SPI, so we are going to select SPI, which is already been selected by default. Now this is a 25 series, so we are using 25 series over here, and these are the options which you can use. This is the read ID option. Right now nothing is connected, so you can see everything is read ID is 0. There is no detection over here because no IC is present, and this is your read IC program. Then this is for programming, and this is erase, and this is for verification. So this is a very simple programmer and one of the cheapest programmer available in the market, which you can use it. So here I am going to do one thing. I am going to connect the board with a clip. So we'll see how we can do the programming of this IC with the help of CH431A. So I have shown you the installation. Now we will proceed with the flashing of this BIOS. So let's move to the flashing part. So we are taking this board as an example for flashing this BIOS using CH431A. Okay, so for that I will be using the clip over here. This is a clip which is available, which we will be using. Before that, I would like to explain you something that you should know: the pin number 1 of both the things, that is your clip as well as this IC, and how to place your clip to this programmer. So what I'm going to do is, here you can see there is one dot over here. I don't think so it will be visible on the camera, but the dot is over here. There is a dot on the IC always. You can, if you can see it, this is the pin number 1, and always there is a mark on the board as well. You can see one dot is a white dot is over here. This is the mark. From here also you can identify where is the pin number 1. Similarly, of this clip, this red ribbon indicates the pin number 1. So your pin number 1 of this clip and this IC should match. So what we are going to do is, we are going to put the clip first and see whether it has been placed properly or not, else it will not read. So you can see there is some problem with the placement. So I'll make the placing first properly. Now you can see it has been placed perfectly. Okay, now how will you put over here? I already told you this below part is for 25 series and upper part is for 24 series. So this is from the below side. This area is from the below side. This is the pin number, like, goes from, this will be the pin number 1 over here for this clip. So we will be placing the clip over here. So I will be placing the clip over here from the below side. My pin number 1 will be pointing towards the upside. Okay, this will from the upside. So I'll open this and place it. So be very careful while placing. So I have placed it over here. Now this is the connection which I have made. You can also use the SOP8 socket also. For 150 mL, 250 mL, you can use that also directly, but here I am using the clip as it is convenient for reading without removing the IC from the board. So we have placed the clip. Now I will be moving towards the programming part. So what I am going to do is, I have to press on the read ID button first. You can see, as soon as I press on the read ID button, our IC has been detected. This is W25Q64 windbound IC. So I'm going to double click this and it has been selected. Now you can see over here, this has been selected. Now what I have to do is, I have to press on the read button. You can see the reading has been started over here. You can see the reading is going on over here also. The reading has been started. Now CH431 is one of the commonly used programmer, and it is a very low cost programmer which is being used into the market. That's why it is being sold. It is also okay for like project work, etc. So the reading work is going on, and yes, of course it is a bit slower programmer, but it works well for normal use it is okay, but for repair works I don't think so this is a right choice. But normal work, very less work, those who have projects and all, they can use it for programming purpose. It's a good programmer for them in a very low cost. So as soon as the reading will be completed, you will be able to see the data over here. See, the light has stopped. The reading has been completed over here. This is the backup from here you can do. You can save the file. And like 123.bin. You can save it. Then if you try to find it out, this is your file. And you can see it on the hex also. This is the backup file which you got. So this is how you can take the backup from the BIOS of SPI-25. Similarly, if you need for that SPI-24, you have to put the clip on the upper side, and from there you can take the backup. So if you want to get the knowledge on BIOS modding, you can just purchase our Hindi edition. All the videos are available already, and along with that there are many case studies as well as some videos theoretically on impedance and voltages are also there. With the help of DSO, how you can check the motherboard are also included on this videos. The complete package is of around 40 plus videos. You can, if you like, you can just purchase them. It is a full of knowledge. You can enjoy the videos, and it is a 100% money back videos. Your money will not be wasted for that. So if you like to join our BIOS and schematics group, you can also contact us for joining that. As well as, we also have a training program of laptop chip level, advanced level. If you like to join that, you can also come and join that. So thanks for watching Aditya 11 TTT YouTube channel. If you like our channel, do hit the subscribe button, like, share and comment. Thanks a lot.